Welcome to Unsightly Opinions. My name's Tamara. Today, I want to do a makeup review, something I have never done on this channel before, but something I am very curious about. If you're not into makeup, that's cool. I will have another blindness video coming out Saturday, but if you do enjoy makeup, stay tuned, because we're going to be reviewing Il Makiage's foundation and concealer.
I just wanted to pop in for a moment and mention this is not sponsored in any way, shape, or form, so these reflect my views and mine alone.
I don't know if it's just me, but over the last few months, my social media feeds from Instagram to Facebook to everywhere else has been bombarded by ads for Il Makiage. I'm gonna play a little clip for you here.
This foundation covers everything, but it still looks like skin. Insane.
This is a way better match than I get in stores.
It feels like I have nothing on my face.
Honestly, can't even tell I'm wearing foundation.
My foundation has never looked this good.
They claim that they're weightless, that they're the best color match ever, that they don't feel like they're wearing foundation, that it's flawless coverage. I am going to put that to the test. As a person with albinism, I sit on the extremes in terms of skin tone. I have never been able to find a foundation that is a perfect match for my skin, and I have tried everything from inexpensive products in drugstores all the way up through Sephora and MAC to very high-end products sold in department stores, and I have never, ever found anything that works for me. I am presently wearing Kat Von D, which is close, but it oxidizes, it's a little heavier than I'd like, so if we can find something else that works better, I'm going to be so excited. I want to go through the entire process today, go through their quiz, we're going to see how accessible that is to do independently, and we're going to rate the products and actually put them on once they arrive. So let's dive in and see if Il Makiage is worth all the hype.
Okay, so we're in the quiz now. I've managed to navigate through everything with voiceover. It's asked me what my skin type is. Okay, so dry, married to my moisturizer. I think my skin is combination, so I'm going to select that. Next. I typically prefer medium to full. Usually let's go with natural. Okay, so it's going to now show us photos. This may be where it gets inaccessible. Okay, so presumably these are skin tone images. I'm going to go with fair to light because that appears to be the first option. Oh boy. So it actually did pretty well with the first set where it was actually talking about tones, but this is just listed as 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I don't know what each image is. Presumably, based on the previous page, I'm going to assume the lightest option is the first option, but I have no way of telling, so that's what we're going to go with. I think this is now images again in terms of skin tone, but doesn't say specifically what each one is. So I'm just going to go with the first option and hope that's the right one. I don't know what I'm agreeing to at this point because it's just a series of multiple images every time. So I don't know what it's asking me to do, so I'm just going to keep selecting the first option. Undertone. I have been told different things over the years about my undertone, but presently I'm using a neutral undertone, so I'm going to go with that. Okay, I do wear gold and silver jewelry. I can't tan because I'm albino, and you can see all of my veins because I have no skin pigment, but my veins look red and blue and purple and all kinds of colors depending on where they are, so I don't know, but I'm presuming this is correct. My skin doesn't change, so lighter? Final category image, okay. So it has no information as to what this image is. It's just describing it as image. I'm going to go with lighter because my skin tone's lighter than anyone's skin tone. I apply with my fingers and then with a brush. Just use primer. Probably 2 to 4 days a week. More than a year. Okay, so I selected a few of those. Age bracket. Okay, so let's see. Okay, I'm gonna fill in my email, but I'm not gonna put it here for you all to see. At this point, it wants me to fill in all of my personal details, and it wants me to fill in all of my payment information and shipping address. I'm not going to show you any of that. It's fairly standard. Overall, I think the accessibility is about average. There were some image descriptions. It could have been a lot better on the quiz in terms of telling me what I was selecting in those groups of 1, 2, or 3. I have gone back with somebody and double checked. The 1, 2, and 3 were shades of skin tone within groupings. So what that means is in each group, 1 was the lightest and 3 was the darkest, but it was showing you varieties within that. I think it was trying to get you to choose your shade based on images of other people. Maybe not the most accurate, and I think there's definitely ways to make those more accessible just so you know what you're clicking on, even if you can't necessarily tell by looking yourself what shade your skin is. So I'm going to send this off and wait for it to arrive.
It's now a few days later and my box has arrived. I am fresh-faced and ready to swatch to see if this makeup is going to be my perfect match. I do love the try before you buy, so let's see what's inside this box. We have, I have already taken a sneak peek, the foundation. We have eyeliner, which is our free gift, which I'm going to have a lot of fun with. We have our foundation brush, and we have our concealer. So I'm going to open these all up. So here is the concealer. It's in a long tube. It feels relatively heavy, so nice quality. The makeup brush feels pretty nice. It feels like synthetic. Maybe not the softest thing ever, but for a free add-on, not mad. Here is the eyeliner. You said it was an ink liner, I believe. I've never tried an ink liner. I'm not very good at eyeliner, so maybe something to try on another day. And finally, the foundation, which is in a very heavy glass bottle, feels very nice quality. I'm ready to get swatching. I want to compare Il Makiage's foundation and concealer in terms of color and feel to what I'm presently using, which is Kat Von D's Lock It Concealer in shade Whiteout. It is, as far as I'm aware, the very lightest concealer and foundation on the market. I'm going to swatch this on my wrist here. The concealer has absolutely no pigment in it, so it's going to be lighter than my skin tone because even though I have no pigment, my skin isn't completely white. What does it look like to you, Robbie?
Whiteout is the best way to describe it. Liquid paper whiteout.
It's not necessarily my favorite, but again, it's the closest I've been able to find to a match. So let's test Il Makiage and see if it comes close. I'm going to swatch that below. How would you say that compares?
Well, it's decidedly not white. It's certainly more of a flesh tone, has some yellows and some browns kind of to it, whereas the other one is no other way to describe it but white.
So would you describe it as darker than my skin tone or lighter?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Darker.
Okay, so that's not a good start. Let's see where we get to on the foundation. I'm now going to swatch the Kat Von D shade 40 Neutral on my wrist just below that. This, I believe, does have some pigment in it, but it's lighter than even the lightest shade of Fenty. So how does that look?
Yep, I would agree. It's again, I think I would probably describe it as a white, but in contrast, it does have a little bit more pigment than the white out, like you mentioned, but certainly much lighter than the Il Makiage.
And would you describe it as similar to my skin tone or significantly different? Lighter, darker, orangier, yellower, pinker?
It's whiter.
It's whiter than my foundation. Okay, well, we'll see how it looks when it blends in. And finally, we have Il Makiage in shade 010. Let's see how it compares. It's got a lid on here, and we're just going to pump a little bit out onto my finger. How is that in comparison?
Tasty.
Tasty?
Yeah, again, it's more brown than I would say white.
So is it lighter, darker, neutral?
A little bit lighter than the last entrant from Il Makiage. Darker than both of the two from Kat Von D.
Typically, your concealer should be lighter than your foundation, so I am a little bit surprised that they sent me a darker concealer than the foundation. But another thing that they say in all of their ads is that when it blends in, that's when it really does its magic and it's able to match your skin tone. So I'm gonna just try and blend in the Il Makiage up my arm here a little bit. It does feel nice. It doesn't feel very heavy. I wouldn't say it feels like nothing. It definitely feels like you're wearing concealer. It has a bit of a floral scent to it, but it's not obnoxious. Maybe not my favorite scent, but it isn't in your face. It's not tacky, it's not sticky. It does blend very nicely. Do you see it as streaky, or did it blend relatively smooth on my skin here?
Yeah, quite smooth.
Okay, and I'm going to take my other forearm and put on Kat Von D. And I'm going to try and go on the same part of my forearm, and I'm just going to blend it in. So how would you compare those, Robbie?
I would have to say the Kat Von D actually looks like it blends and is continuous with your skin tone, whereas the Il Makiage is a stark contrast.
And just to be triply sure, I am going to put the Kat Von D on one cheek and the Il Makiage on the other. It does smell a little bit chemically now that it's closer to my face. How would you say that blends? Because that feels blended now.
It looks actually quite greasy and much more streaky on your face.
Oh, really? Than this side?
Mm-hmm. That side looks dry and, again, continuous. I don't know if you just applied more on this side.
I don't think so. I only did, half a pump. But it feels like it's leaving granules on my skin, almost. It's almost like when you wear sunscreen for too long and it starts kind of rolling off your skin. How is the color match? So compared to the neck, that's usually where it's going to be the...
Yeah, it's pretty obvious there. On this side, less so for sure.
And I mean, I didn't put on any kind of primer or anything underneath that might change the color because I wanted it to be as kind of foundation dependent as possible. So what's our verdict? I think it's pretty clear that Il Makiage does not have a shade that's light enough for me. I am going to reach out to them and see what they say. I'm going to send them some photos and express my concern that if they're claiming they have the widest range of shades, that they really should be able to accommodate all skin tones. And when you're on the extremes, you're still a skin tone that should be matched. Whether you're going to sell a million or 10. This has been an ongoing struggle for me since I was a teenager. I've never been able to find foundation matches. The first time I walked into a Sephora, I was told I should just go out and get white face paint. It was a really demeaning experience because there was nothing to match me. And now I have something that's close, but it isn't exact. And I know a lot of people struggle with foundation matching, but when you're on the extremes, it can feel really isolating when you want to be part of a makeup community, when you want to explore and create, or even just feel feminine and feel dressed up and express yourself through your makeup, and you can't do that because you can't access the same products as everyone else. So if you have a favorite foundation or you want me to try more foundations, if you have a suggestion, I am all ears. I will try anything from drugstore to super expensive. If something actually is the right color, I'm willing to pay for it. Double points if it has SPF in it. Let me know if you want to see more makeup videos. I had a lot of fun filming this. If you want to support the channel, you can always do so by liking, commenting, subscribing, and sharing, or engaging in any other way. But that's all I have for you today. I'd love to know your thoughts down below, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.